Did you know that more than 100,000 people a day are downloading game apps? Mobile apps have become a normal part of everyday lives. Now there's a new exciting sports app that lets you play along with your favorite professional sports team in real time. With this fantastic app, you can predict the next play and even outguess your favorite team members. The more predictions you get correct, the more points you receive. Points can be exchanged for cool prizes, like your favorite jerseys, hats, airline tickets, sports tickets, even a new car. You can play this amazing sports app by yourself, with your friends, or even with a large group of fans from all over the world. This incredible sports app is called FireFan, and it's available right now. Check it out. Sign up today at www.freefirefanapp.com.
Hi folks, it's a holiday season with hope in the air. Things to look forward to and no time for despair. Health can be a challenge, and so can the mail. So Get the Tea wants to help you by giving you a sale. Buy 2 months of Super Tea and get 1 month for free. No limit. That's buy 2 months of Super Tea and get 1 month free. That's a savings of $35. Where? GetTheTea.com. That's GetTheTea.com. Scroll down on the front page and find the buy two, get one free ad. Click it and save. Orders over $100 get free shipping. Send the gift of life. Change tea at GetTheTea.com. We have many, many non-GMO organic supplements just waiting for you. This holiday season, enjoy health and Thanksgiving with GetTheTea.com. Want to call us? 928-308-0408. That's 928-308-0408. GetTheTea.com is a proud sponsor of Doing What's Right. That's GetTheTea.com.
For more local radio every day, tune in to KCAA Loma Linda.
You just entered the Gotcha Zone. Eilon up to the start line and get ready to race with your host, Joe Britt. It's time for Gotcha Racing, live on KCAA 1050.
Ladies and gentlemen, start your engines and get ready for an action-packed, fun-filled hour of everything a motorhead ever loved or lived. Gotcha Racing with Joe Britt.
Welcome to Gotcha Racing. This is Joe Britt.
Good doggy. I'm back in the seat. I'm back in Central. It's been a long time, folks. It feels like I've been away for decades. Out in the field doing my thing and doing the campaigning season. Man, it feels, seems like the room has gotten a lot smaller since the last time I graced my presence with this area. But anyway, glad to be here, glad to be back home, and glad to be sitting down in front of my main man, Carlos. Carlos is our engineer. He's going to be my engineer from now on, and he kind of started me in the business a couple of years ago, you know, and he's been here, and I've been here, and now we're back on the, it's just reversal now. Right, so it's working. Carlos, how you doing, buddy? You're okay?
Yeah, I'm alive, doing well.
That's good, man. That's always good to hear, folks. So that's going to be Carlos, the one of the fantastic engineers we have here at KCAA Radio. You know, we're the top dogs in the area. We are the number one top dogs in the area, and that's my opinion. But you know, opinions are like armpits. Everybody has at least two of them. But nevertheless, we're broadcasting big time now. Well, you know, we've always broadcast for the last 13 years on KCAA 1050 AM radio. Okay, now we're on 106.5 FM, but guess what? Our new baby has been on the air for about three months now. 102.3 FM. That's right, 102.3 FM. So, who's the big dogs in the area? It has to be us, folks. You have to be under a friggin' rock to not to hear our broadcasts, our station's broadcasts here in the area. We cover everybody. We go from Mo Valley all the way around to Yucaipa, you know? So Riverside, Mo Valley, you know, I even heard it in Chino. So our broadcasts, I mean, we are out there, folks. We're out there. But let me digress a little bit and start my open as I always do. I always have to pay homage to the people that were instrumental in getting me here, okay? So here we go. I come to you a humble man, A humble man that is a reflection of God's grace and greatness. A humble man that is standing on shoulders of ancestors. Hello, America! Look alive, California! Wake up, San Bernardino! Stand up and be counted in an empire. For this is your host, Joe Britt, coming to you loud, clear, and strong from the desert to the sea. Broadcasting on the powerful KCAA Talk Radio, 1050 AM. 106.5 FM and 102.3 FM. We're the big dog, folks. And I guess that deserves a bow wow. Ruff. We're the big dogs and we carry the big stick, okay? So, weather. We'll start with the weather. Weather's absolutely great here, man. Carlos, what's the temperature out there?
Right now, we're at 61.
Not bad at all. Not bad at all for a winter day. A winter day in California, but that's how we roll, folks. Someone says it doesn't rain in California. Yeah, sometimes it does, but nevertheless, the sun is out. You can walk around. It's nice. Back east, they're catching all kind of havoc with the snow and accidents and whatnot. But we are living large in California, and you got to respect the place. You got to respect it. If you don't respect it, hey, pack up your bags and go home. So, that old saying, hey, welcome to California, now go home. All right, so let's do a little house cleaning here. Now, I think the numbers have changed, so Carlos, here we go. Listen to this. For those of you who want to call in to our number and just listen, now, not talk, but just listen to this great broadcast we have, the number used to be 823. Has that changed? Okay. Give us a number, Carlos.
All right. Just give me a second to get a hold of it.
Okay. So for those of you who want to call into the studio, that number is 888-909-1050. Call into the studio, long distance, 888-909-1050. The local calls in the IE would be 909-888-5222 or 5224. Now, for those of you who just want to listen, you could be under a rock, you could be somewhere, so use your smartphone, use your dumb phone, use your cell phone, or use your house phone. That number is
701-801-4444.
Repeat that, please.
That's 701-801-4444.
Thank you, Mr. Carlos. All right, so we can be found at our great we, meaning Gotcha Racing Life, can be found at our great website, which is kcaaradio.com. Now, for those of you who are just now listening and you wonder, who is this guy, talking about this, talking about that? Well, we've been on a couple of years or so, and you can go to our webpage, okay? Look to the far left. You'll see schedules. Hit schedules, go down to your Saturday's lineup, and you will see us, Gotcha Racing Live. Now, all those are 2 years worth of, 2.5 years worth of podcasts that you can go through and pick and choose and listen to what we've done in the past and see if we're legit or not. See if I'm just trying to blow smoke up your skirt, okay? Which I'm not. I try to be open and I try to be legit, and I promise I won't lie to you. I don't have to. I got a history, folks. I got a history in this game of automotive. Automotive manufacturing and automotive customization and racing. Been there, done that, got the shirt, and don't wear it. Okay, we can be found on Facebook under Gotcha Racing TV. We can be found under my name, Joe Britt, B-R-I-T-T. Hey, check us out and see what we've done. Now, for those of you that want to email me, that number would be, address would be jbritt, B-R-I-T-T, at kcaa at gmail.com. Now, we also have a sister company, which is Gotcha Racing TV, all right? Now, so those numbers, that address would be grtv.media@gmail.com. That's all for you Gotcha Racing TV fans. We're out and about. We're on the different tracks. We're at the different car shows. And we go both ways. Hold on a minute. When I say go both, we go both ways. Either we're on the track and we're filming with the crew, okay, and we're getting those live action shots and we're putting them on YouTube. Or we're on the tracks we're on the different tracks and we're doing live broadcasts. Or we're just on a track and we're doing a pre-recording that we would put on a show later on. But we're out and about, man. We're out and about. The last event that I went to, folks, it was the LA Auto Show, which was about 2 weeks ago, or was it? Yeah, about 2 weeks ago. And I missed my media days because I had to do engineering work. But nevertheless, I bought a ticket. I, Joe Britt, bought a ticket to the LA Auto Show. Normally, we get in for free for the past 14 years and media days. But nevertheless, so what I found kind of interesting at the LA Auto Show was, of course, the real cool cars were always there. Some of the prototypes are there. But, you know, Ferrari's no longer there. And I didn't see Bentley. I didn't see Rolls-Royce. So it seems like all the and that's probably based on the economy, too, you know. Why would they want to come out and spend, say, $200,000 for 2 weeks, or maybe $300,000? The economy probably won't be able to bear, you know, giving them the return on their investment. Yeah, that might be so. But I did my live show from there, and we were downstairs at the garage, right? And that's where all the happenings for me. I mean, upstairs, you have all the OEM cars. You know, you got your Chevy, you got your Dodge, you got your Nissans. You have all your import manufacturers. You have a lot of the domestic manufacturers that are there. But it wasn't that many exotics. And I tell you, man, I like. I just get a high looking at the exotics, and so all that was downstairs. The Lamborghinis were downstairs. The custom built Ferraris were downstairs. Okay, Alfa Romeos customs were downstairs. So all the custom vehicles were downstairs, and that would probably be where I would be debuting our Stallion GT1. And hopefully we can get together and do it for next year. It'll probably more likely be downstairs to save some cash. And it's a lot of folks, you know, milling around downstairs. And so we tried to do that about 15 years ago. And one of our sponsors didn't come through for that. So there we were. And I will do it again. I have not stopped. I just got very, very busy. So, listen to this, guys. Before we get off into our show, there is some interesting. I was just checking the internet, and I was wondering, what are the fastest cars under $100,000? And what do you guys think? Now, if you guys know something that I don't know, why don't you call in? But let me give you, according to Audio Bytes, right? I'll give you the first 10. So it's the Mustang, the 5.0 Mustang, the 017 model, under $100,000. And if you've seen that one, that is a gorgeous piece of machinery. I tell you, I really got a Jones for that Mustang. It really looks hot this year. Then we have the 2016 Corvette Z06. The price tag is around $80,000. Not a bad ride. 650 horsepower, 6.2 liter supercharged V8 motor. Hey, it will run. It will run. They have a pedal shifter, a 8-speed pedal shifter automatic. Not bad. You know what? I used to like the stick shifts. I really did, you know. You can hear the gears, but man, I've gotten over that. I like, just give me a automatic that I can push the pedal to the metal and that go forward and give me 100 plus miles an hour whenever I can, mind you, whenever I can. And that's it. So I'm looking at an optional 8-speed pedal shift automatic. Ooh, doggy. Wonder how that feels under you. And then there's the 2016 Ford Shelby. The GT350R, and that's hanging around $62,000. 526 horses, 429 pound of torque, and it'll do 0 to 60 in 3.7 seconds. Not bad at all. That, but you know what? That Ford is on point, man. Really, really. And Shelby has gotten a hold to it. And I wonder what Selena's doing. I wonder what his packages are doing. You know? Selena has a twin screw setup, which is a supercharged setup. But I don't know the specs on that. But maybe we'll get that. We'll have Selena back on the show again. We had him on 2 years ago, and he got a lot of good information out of his headquarters. Okay. My doggy, 2015 Dodge Viper. Man, the Vipers are still going out? Interesting. 8.4 V10 and 645 horses. 600 pound square foot of torque. Where could you run something like that at? You know, it'll do 60 in 3.7 seconds. Where would I run that? Now, the longest stretch that I could probably imagine would be from San Bernardino to Las Vegas. You know, some of those areas, you won't see a CHP. You can probably, you know, put the metal to the floor 5 minutes or so. But and that's really hauling butt. That's really hauling butt. But if you get caught, hey, that's on you, folks. If you get caught 100 miles an hour, I was told they just tow your car home and you have to get out and walk somewhere. So, and that's a pretty hefty fine. So you didn't hear it here, but hey, don't throw caution to the wind, okay? Here we go. 2016 Porsche 911 Carrera S. Those are going for right under $100,000. Those are $98,000. Not bad. 3.8 liter, six-cylinder. 400 horsepower and 325 pounds foot of torque. No kidding. All right, and the next one would be the 2016 BMW M3. Good looking car. Suggested retail price is around 63,000 and 425 horses and 7-speed automatic manual transmission. No kidding. Interesting. The only thing about the Beamers, I love the Beamers, man. I really do. But I tell you, if that sucker sneezes, just like the Mercedes. Yeah, I got a Mercedes. And if that sucker sneezes, that's a $500 hit. You know, it gets a cold. You got to take it into the dealership. Be prepared to pay about $500 just for that medical checkup. All right, 2016 Cadillac CTSV. Those, you know, I heard them run. I was in one about a year ago. A buddy of mine put a supercharger on it, and this is a supercharged 640. But I tell you, that rascal is 6.2 liter V8. It will put your head back in that seat. I am not kidding. And I had flashbacks of what happened to the guy. Fast and Furious guy, you know, when he was in the car and his buddy was testing that Porsche out, and I said, oh man, no, you got to stop this and let me out, because I don't want to be a victim of speed. And but he got on it for a minute, and I was really shaking, because I didn't know the guy's skill level, but nevertheless, he wanted to show me how many horses and how powerful this CTS was. And let me tell you, folks, that CTS is no joke. It is no joke. That motor, that beast is no joke. And if they're done right, where suspension-wise, you can race those rascals. I do believe you can put them on the track, and you can haul some good butt. All right, almost done here. 2016 Mercedes C63S AMG. Suggested retail price hangs around $73,000. And what do we got there? We have 6.2 liter V8, cranks out about 503 ponies, and it also has a 7-speed automatic manual transmission. Beautiful car. But if it sneezes, $500. All right, Alfa Romeo. You know, I remember back in the day when the Alfa Romeos came out, well, back in the 70s, and I tell you, they've grown. And it looks nothing like it did back in the day. This is the Alfa Romeo, a 2016 4C. Suggested retail price about $55,000. It'll do 60 seconds and 4.0 to 60 in 4.5 seconds. And where are we? It's, of course, it's Italian, 1.7 liter turbocharged, and it produces 237, I should say, Italian stallions, horses. Not bad, small car, not bad at all. And then I guess the last one under $100,000, I would say, has to be the Porsche Cayman S, and that's at $64,000. And you know, those are 0 to 60 in 4.5 minutes, seconds, I should say, not minutes. Hey, so here's some interesting news. Dale Earnhardt Jr., you know, God rest Papa soul, but the son, you know, he had an accident, and he's trying to get cleared to come back and race. He is trying to get cleared to come back, and I'm just wondering, you know, what do you guys think about it? Do you think he should just retire and just work on his team and, you know, work on his kids and just say, you know, I'm done, and not get back in the car? What do you guys think? I'm itching to hear from you. So we'll see what he does, but that's his own thing. Hey, you know, the Grand National Rosa Show is coming up in January 27th and 29th of in a couple of weeks, I guess. That is an awesome show, and you have to be invited. You know, that show is the top of the top of all the elites. I'm not kidding. Fantastic cars that are there, and these are guys that are put stuff together in their shops, putting stuff together in their garages. But I tell you what, it has, in order to compete at that level and at the Grand National, the car has to start. Buddy of mine is a top electrician. You've heard him once before on the show, Joe Ellis. I mean, hell, I've seen him do submarines, you know, rewiring submarines, and also the big Delta planes. Anyway, he got caught. Here's a story real quick. There was a contender that brought his car from Canada, and it was one of the top cars at the show. But like I said, if it doesn't start, you're out. So he called Joe about 12 o'clock midnight, and he worked on it for about 4 hours and got that rascal kicking, and that guy won best of show. And this was about 4 years ago. It's a gold two-seater. I think it was a Ford. Really nice car. But nevertheless, if it don't start, you're not going nowhere. Now, Sacramento has their Autorama, and that's coming February 17th and 19th of next year, 2017. Do you believe this year has gone by that quickly? I just can't believe that. I mean, wow, man, it seemed like we just had the Christmas show a couple of weeks ago, you know? And if you can remember, I had the DJ in the back, is playing this Christmas music, and it was pretty cool. But nevertheless, I know I'm running my mouth, but you know, I'm excited to be here. I'm excited to be back in the seat, man. You just don't know, and I get to communicate with all you guys out there. Yay! I can communicate. So, without further ado, we have our road warrior, Chris. Now, folks, you've heard Chris for going on about a year now. And Chris is in the motors. His mind and frame is motorcycles. He's also an engineer also, you know. He's a smart cookie. But he rides bikes, and he knows the ins and outs about the motorcycle industry. And pretty much where all the boats and everything that concerns a motorcycle, he knows. And he hasn't let us down yet. So I got him on the line. Chris, the Road Warrior. You're on the line, buddy?
Yeah, I'm here. How are you doing?
Man, I'm running my mouth. Yeah, no. Carlos, pump him up a little bit. Okay. There you go.
I suffer from the same illness, my friend.
Yeah, I know. And that's why I would never give you the mic and let you put it in your hands, because, man, we'd have a two-hour show.
But
hold on a minute. It'd be worthwhile information, and I know it. But we just don't have the time to do it. But nevertheless, dude, what you got for us today?
Well, I think sometimes you might give me too much credit, but hey, you know what? I'll take it. Hey, you know, last time that we got together and talked a little bit here on the air. We discussed, you know, storing our bikes for the wintertime and how to prep them and all that. But I'm going to say, you know, I was talking about those of us that don't store our bikes for the wintertime and choose to ride during this time of year. Out here where we live, of course, you know, you can almost ride 365, 24/7. So for those who can, that is, for those who don't live in high blasting winds, blizzards, ice, and snow, the rest of us who want to stay on board, you know, this is for you. And, you know, we need to prep ourselves to be able to ride in this, what some people call inclement weather. Others just call it weather. And be prepared. And that's one of my things I always talk about, being prepared. So on the motorcycle itself, if you have been contemplating putting on a windshield or an aftermarket fairing, this is the time to do it. You know what? Buy yourself an early Christmas gift, you know, or maybe hint around, and find one. It'll make a drastic difference in the winter ride for you, be able to break that wind and get it around you, no matter what you're wearing. It'll be a big help. I happen to have a full fairing on my motorcycle, and it does a great job on keeping the direct wind off of me. From there...
Hold on a minute. Now, you drive a motorhome. We all know this, okay? This big two-wheel motorhome. And that rascal comes with windscreen from the factory, right? The big Goldwing?
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah, true,
okay.
True. This one does. My other ones did not.
So you know the difference between that air hitting you and not hitting you, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Know, we're talking about as much as 20 or 30 degrees of wind chill sometimes, depending on how fast you're riding.
Okay. If you can remember a couple of years ago, and this happened to you, not me, and you told the story about, and we'll go back to finishing what you're talking about, the story about the wind was so great on the 210 that you were almost at a 45-degree angle?
Yeah, right. Yeah, I remember it.
Now, you know, we had a windstorm last Saturday.
Yeah.
Remember that?
Yeah.
And I'm wondering what knucklehead was out there in the conditions of that windstorm on the two-wheeler, you know, and if they made it or not. But I remember you saying that, man, you were so glad to get home, you kissed the ground.
Basically, yeah, pretty much. I almost kissed the ground before I got home, to be honest with you on that one. There was a knucklehead out on a big blue motorcycle in the last one, too. But he took a different path this time, so he stayed low.
Okay, I got
you. But, yeah, that's something to keep also be on the lookout for is the winds. But I'll tell you what, dressing properly will keep you warm. And whether you got wind or not, you're going to generate your own wind just riding. So if you look out and go, hey, you know, it's only supposed to be 55 degrees today, that's not bad. I'm going to wear some of my light gear. You know, well, think about two things. One, when the sun goes down, that 55 drops to 45 pretty quickly. And if you're riding, drop it another 10 degrees or better, and then prepare for that number, because that will make all the difference in the world. Now, I wear wool socks, you know, keep the feet warm, because, again, if any part of you really gets chilled or cold, the rest of it suffers too. You want to be able to feel the gears, feel the brakes. So, you know, keep your feet warm if you can. Good pair of pants, of course. If you like to wear leather riding pants, that's even better. That breaks the wind a lot better. Long underwear, thermal underwear, is also a plus if you're going to be getting down into that sub-low 40s and 30s type of temperatures. That's highly recommended.
Chris, hold on a minute. Now,
yeah.
When you're on a, say, the pants, the cowboys used to wear, I don't know what they call them, but they go over your pants, but it's not, it's not pants. It just goes over the front.
Leather chaps.
Chaps, that's what they're called. Okay.
Yeah.
And those are still available in the market, right?
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely. Yeah. A lot of guys wear them, for style purposes, but I'll tell you what, and the Cowboys want them to protect their legs from the underbrush. But as far as modern-day Cowboys and our iron horses that we ride, it breaks the wind great, you know. It is a plus, and it is also inexpensive in the cost of, you know, comparison to, say, full leather pants, you know. So they still cost a couple bucks, but, again, I'm glad you brought that up. That is another alternative that won't necessarily break the bank.
Okay, so
keeping the legs warm.
So check this out. For the folks that are on a budget, let's say, and I'm going to ride in temperatures of 40. Yeah, about 40.
Okay.
If I had long johns, thick socks, boots, Levi's, and the chaps, what do you think? I'm okay?
Oh, yeah, you're good. You're good. You might not even have to have the chaps.
No kidding.
But you know, that is a plus layer. And plus layers are always a good thing. And then going up from there, also, as you put on these different layers of pants, you want to also meet that with the same amount of layers, plus one on the top, and tuck them in intermittently, interlace them at the waist so that you don't get any air gaps where things will blow up, you know, up the back, up the side, whatever. So, you know, tuck the first layer T-shirt into into the underwear, and then alternate from there coming up. And when I say meet the same layers plus, that plus is the last thing would be your jacket, or whatever type of jacket you're utilizing. So if you're not riding in the rain, untreated leather jacket will work out fine, and numerous other types of jackets, even a ski jacket. They're good for keeping you warm. Don't always break the wind very well, but you know, if you're going to be in the rain, if you're going to be getting wet, then make sure your leather is treated with some kind of a coating, because untreated leather will literally just let the water come through after a while. I made that mistake once, and that changed my whole attitude.
The thing that gets me is when I used to ride is the gloves. Man, I hate cold fingers, man. I really do. I can't function, man, with cold fingers, dude.
I carry two different types of gloves. I have my summer and, you know, summer, spring, fall gloves that are just leather, thin leather coat, enough to keep my hands comfortable, and if I go down, keep them safe. And then I've got my insulated leather gloves that actually have a rain cover that folds out of them and goes over the top of them and keeps them waterproof as well, or water resistant, I should say, and it's really waterproof. So, you know, they're heavier gloves. Those things I've ridden down into the 30s with and have yet to ever have my hands get cold from them. And then, of course, there's the guys out there that have the extra custom touch of, you know, heated grips. I call them cheaters.
Heated grips, not bad at all. Wow.
Heated grips and heated seat. Yeah, you can load up if you've got the funds to do it. You can make those alterations on your bike. I've chosen not to. For me, it's just one more thing to go broken.
Yeah,
break me and break on my bike. So.
Hey, listen, Chris. Listen to this. So, I'm kind of entertaining the thought of getting, you know, I like bikes, to getting a road bike. And yeah. I was looking at the Star. I don't want to put too much money into it, because I got other things to put money into, but just to get out and roll. If and when I do decide to get that, and if Sturgis is coming up, you got time to ride?
Oh, wow, an invitation on the air. Okay, not like you never put me on a spot before.
No. I just said, do you have time to ride? And I said, if and when.
I can always make time to ride. I've always got vacation time I can always plug into. Honestly, I've never made that trip before. I've never made that distance in one shot before. So that would be
something.
Something to entertain, you thought of, yeah.
We'll talk. It came across my mind right now. Go, I've never been to Sturgis on a bike, you know.
I've never been there at all, so yeah. that would be a first for me on many levels.
Yeah, well, we'll talk off air about that.
But anyway, the last thing I want to touch base on, is, as I'm moving up the body here, is something I had covered. You know, under your helmet, something that covers your neck and over the top of your head, there's several items on available that are different materials. I wear one that is made of wool, a knit wool, and I'll tell you what, you keep your neck covered, get it tucked up under your jacket, and keep your head warm and your neck warm, no air to get down into your jacket, and that will make a lot of difference. If you're going to put money into anything right now, for riding in the cool evenings or cool days, get something that covers the head, you know, down the neck and around the neck and such, and keeps the wind off your off of that part of you, and that will make a difference in the world. I actually start to sweat sometimes once I put that on, and between that and my gloves, I can actually forego almost another layer at that point. It definitely keeps you warm at that point.
Okay. So,
and then, of course, if you have a full-face helmet, you've got a plus on the guys who wear open face.
Who in the heck? Well, you know what? I almost said, who in the heck wears a helmet without a full face? But I've seen them.
There's lots of them. But, you know, even then, you know, that full cover of, you know, some kind of wool knit cover will make a big difference even if you wear open face. A lot of guys still out there choose right open face, and you know, I respect that.
Okay.
I respect freedom of choice very highly.
Good enough. So, well, dude, you know what? I appreciate your time, and I know if you could talk to 12 o'clock, I know that, but I got to continue with the show, man. You've always come to the table with a lot of great information for the listenership out there, and I really appreciate all the knowledge that you do have, and I'm going to talk to you about that. I might get that bike. I don't know. But it's going to be a road bike, not a Rice Rocker like my kid had, but a road bike that I can get on and put my big butt on and just roll with it. Dude, thank you very much for calling in, dude. And
hey, enjoy the ride, guys. And, I'm glad I can be part of the family still.
Enjoy the ride. Take care of yourself. All right. Thank you. That was Chris, the Road Warrior. Carlos, why don't you put on a set of commercials for us? Let me get ready to go to the next segment, and we can roll right along. Folks, this is Joe Britt, come to you loud and strong from the desert to the sea on the powerful KCAA Talk Radio 1050, 106.5, 102.3 FM, and 1050 AM. We're the big dogs in the area. We'll be right back.
Sie hören jetzt Gotcha Racing live mit Ihrem Gastgeber Joe Britt.
Do you like cars, racing, adventure and speed, motorsports of any kind? If it has speed, high performance, or burns octane, there's a brand new show for you. Do you have 1030 weight in your blood, or are you running on 104 performance octane? Then gear up for a brand new show on KCAA called Gotcha Racing. Tune in Saturdays at 4 p.m. with host Joe Britt for news, interviews, and all kinds of stuff you can use about racing and the automotive world. Whether it's learning how to put spark plugs in or spark up your supercharger, Joe's got the answer for you. Gotcha Racing. Find out how Joe built the Stallion GT1 exotic sports car, or hear the area's best experts on automotive questions. It's Gotcha Racing, right here, where we put you in the driver's seat and it doesn't stop till you cross the finish line. Saturdays at 4 p.m. right here on KCAA. It's Gotcha Racing.
Well, see you later. Come on, guys, let's go.
Oh, no.
Don't worry about a thing, pretty lady. You're in good hands with J&K Auto Body Paint and Repair. J&K Auto Body has been serving the Rialto area for years and are considered to be one of the oldest and the best auto body shops in town. The right people with the right tools and the right experience that can give you the service and the quality that you expect. 24-hour, 7-day-a-week towing is available. That's J&K Auto Body, 241 South Palm Avenue, Rialto, California, across the street from the Metrolink station. Call us at 909-875-0400, 909-875-0400. That's 909-875-0400.
You're listening to Gotcha Racing live on KCAA 1050 AM with Joe Britt. Now get to the chopper. Hasta la vista, baby.
شما در حال گوش دادن به برنامه گاچن ریسینگ هستی با صدای جو برید.
U&I Auto Truck Parts and Wrecking is loaded with 15 acres of used, salvaged, and rebuilt parts for your car or truck. Sure, you could go to any wrecking yard, but U&I has what it takes. Expertise, high-quality products, and the finest customer service you'll receive anywhere. U&I makes custom drive shafts, furnishes full warranties on all their parts, and keeps up on industry changes. Call 909-888-6841. You'll be impressed by the fast and friendly response from the U&I skilled staff. You can also go to the Contact Us page and request a part. U&I hours of operation are Monday through Friday, 8 till 5, and Saturday, 8 till 3. U&I Auto Truck Parts and Wrecking is located at 1435 West Rialto Avenue in San Bernardino. Check out the U&I webpage at the letter U, the letter I, autoparts.com, or call 909-888-6841. 909-888-6841.
Okay, folks, we are back. We're back in the seat of Gotcha Racing Live, broadcasting out the out of San Bernardino, California, 106.5, 102.3, and 1050 AM. Hey, Carlos, let's put on NHRA. Now, folks, this is I was talking with the vice president of NHRA. So sit down, relax. Here we go. Put it in, Carlos. Hey folks, here we are again. We're still in the media tent at the Winter Nationals in Pomona, California. And I'm with the top dog here of NHRA, Terry, give me your last. I don't want to mess up your last name. What's your last name?
It's Blunt, pronounced like Mel Blunt.
Blunt, okay. Yeah. And your position with the NHRA?
I'm the Vice President of Communications and Public Relations.
So as I said, folks, I'm talking to one of the big guys, you know, on the fruit, but he's higher up. But nevertheless, how you been?
I've been great. I mean, you know, Joe, we're so excited about this season. It's we really see this. You know, we have a slogan going in this year that we're calling Shifting Gears into a New Era, and we mean that. And we're telling people that because we are going to be so much different, bigger, better than the NHRA has ever been in the past. And it starts, of course, with the Fox television deal, which is really transformative for our sport. You know, we realized that to be considered a true major league sport, you have to go live. And so we're going to have 17 events live this year. We're going to have 4 on the Fox Network live, which has never happened in the history of our sport. You know, years ago, we used to be on Live World of Sports, but that was tape delayed. So it's a big deal for us in terms of our television package and a lot of other new things we have going forward.
Now, last week, you guys were in Phoenix, right, doing testing?
We did. For years, the NHRA has had their preseason test session in Palm Beach, Florida. And it worked well. But the teams had to go all the way across country for the first event here at the Winter Nationals at Pomona. So we felt it was better for them. Most of our teams are headquartered in Indianapolis. It was better for them to come from Indianapolis to Phoenix, do the test there, what we were calling spring training, because obviously spring training will start in a couple of weeks in Phoenix, and then come straight from Phoenix to here, just a 4-hour drive. So not only that, our next event after the Winter Nationals is 2 weeks from now at Phoenix at Wild Horse Pass. So they were actually getting data that they can use in 2 weeks on that track. So it seemed to work out better all the way around. We got a lot of media attention there last week, and we think it was better for the teams. It made it easier for them travel-wise, and it worked out really well. We had a public day on Saturday where people could come watch testing, and we had a lot of media out there. So we thought it was much better than what we'd done in the past.
Well, you know something, I've interviewed a lot of the guys here, and one thing they're mentioning right off the bat, Fox.
Yes.
And my goodness, I'm thinking they must have some kind of training or something.
Well, that's good. They're listening to me then. So, yeah, they know the talking points. So, no, you know, truly, Joe, they're excited about it because they get it. They understand what this means to change the sport. You know, in this era of instantaneous information where young people are on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram and texting, and everything is known within seconds of it happening, you can't be on tape delay. We couldn't have a sport where all the results were known before we went on the air. So we had to go live. We had to put most of our events live. And this year we have 17. And next year we hope to have all of them live. We didn't do that this year because the 7 events that aren't live, we're going directly off a NASCAR race where we get a great bump there from their audience on Fox to go straight from the NASCAR race to our race on tape delay. But the other 17 will be live. And Fox has been great to us. The telecast is going to be dramatically different than anything we've done before. You know, we went in-house with the broadcast because we felt no one's better at telling the stories of our drivers than we are. On the downtime between rounds, we're doing a lot of features on the drivers. We're taking the approach of kind of like they do in the Olympics, Joe, with these features they do on people called up close and personal. Mm. And the reason they do that is you have all these people in the Olympics that are skiers or water polo players or whatever it might be that they don't really know them. So ice skaters, whatever. So they want to do these features on them so people will understand who they are and they'll have a rooting interest in them. Well, that's kind of the approach we're taking with our drivers. We're going to do a lot of features on drivers and make them more personal to our fans. Mm. We want to make the driver's star. You know, for years and years in motorsports, the cars were the stars. And the cars still are a big part of it. But the truth is, the drivers are the stars. And we want to make our drivers bigger stars. We feel we can do that with this TV package. We also have virtual graphics that we're adding. For example, the Sports Vision team, which is the same that does it for the NFL with the first down lines and those kind of things. They are doing virtual graphics for us with a virtual finish line, a virtual starting line. We're going to have things in the lane for each driver showing the driver, their car, who they are, so people will not be confused about which driver is in which lane, and they'll more easily identify that driver with that car. So our virtual graphics package we think will make a big difference. The bottom line is the telecast is going to be so much different than what people have seen before, and we think they're going to notice. We hope they're going to notice.
But Terry, that's almost that's almost like the viewership watching a football game.
Well, it's going to be like
with all the graphics.
Yeah, we're going to have those kind of graphics. And it's the same company, by the way. Sports Vision is the name of the company. We're going to have those kind of graphics. You know, for years people haven't been sure where the finish line was at the end of a race. Well, now we're going to have virtual graphics, like a checkered virtual graphic finish line, so they can see exactly where it is and when they hit that line. And also at the starting line, we're going to have a virtual graphic. But the biggest thing is what we're going to do in the lanes with, like, driver cards. It's kind of like, I guess I'd describe it like a baseball card, where you see the driver's face, their statistics coming in, which car they're in, and which it's going to be in the lane they're in. It's going to be helpful. You know, we've had a problem we felt in the past in that the casual fan wasn't sure which driver was in which lane.
Mm-hmm.
So this will help them recognize them better, help them recognize their car with that driver, and help them kind of learn more about the driver and hopefully become a fan of that car.
Well, you know what? It sounds like you're on the right path. And I tell you, if you can do all of that, which I believe you can, that's going to bring a lot of people watching that TV and watching this game here.
Well, we hope so, especially the four network races we have this summer. You know, our Western Swing, which has always been one of our famous parts of the season, where we go to Denver, Sonoma, and Seattle. The entire Western Swing is now going to be on the Fox network, the big Fox network. So we know, and also our U.S. Nationals in Indianapolis Labor Day weekend. Those are our four network races. And we know that that's going to bring a lot of eyeballs that have never seen the sport before. And we have to capitalize on that. We have to make those people fans that haven't been here before. We want to show them, this is what you're missing, this is why this is cool and trendy. We honestly believe there's no better motorsport for today's young people than our sport. I mean, what other sport do you have a result every 4 seconds, you know, at 300 miles an hour? And, you know, let's face it, kids these days don't have a big, long attention span.
That's right.
And, this is perfect for them, right? So we think we can make them stars. The other thing we want to point out to people that most people don't know is that we have the metrics and the statistical information to prove it, that NHR actually is the number two motorsport in the country to NASCAR. I think people have a misconception that it's IndyCar. Don't get me wrong. I love IndyCar racing. I covered the Indianapolis 500 for 20 years. But we are actually number two in every metric you want to see, in the number of participants, in the number of fans, in any metric you want to try and use. We are number two to NASCAR, and IndyCar is number three, or in some cases Formula One in the U.S. is number three. So we want to emphasize that and capitalize on that, because we don't think the stories have been told, and we don't think a lot of media people realize that. So that's something we're emphasizing as well.
Whatever I can do to help push you along, and to help push this sport through my two stations, 106.5 FM and 1050 AM, all you got to do is give me a jingle and say, Joe, we want you to. Now, I'll do whatever it takes to push this forward.
Well, Joe, we just really appreciate you're here. That means a lot to us. You know, people that really understand racing like you do, we need more of those people coming to our events. And the more people we can get out here like that and get the message across that can actually explain the sport to people where they can understand it and start enjoying it more is very helpful to us. So we're just thrilled you're here.
You know what? My tactic when I interview is not to talk about the speed. Heck, we know you go fast. Not to talk about the tires. We know you got good tires. all these guys who that I have interviewed today, I come from a personal. How's your family?
Yeah.
What are you doing? That kind of a
deal. And that's what we want. Yeah. I mean, that's the thing. That's what we're doing in these stories. Like, we're doing a lot more videos now that we're placing on the website. By the way, we have a newly designed website. We think it's a lot easier for people to access information. But a big part of that is a lot more videos. You know, the truth is, in this era, people will click on a 1 minute or 30-second video a lot more than they'll read a 20-paragraph story.
That's true.
That's just the truth. So we're doing a lot more videos. But in the videos, it's not just about your first place in the standings or something like that. We're doing videos to make them personal about drivers. For example, last week we went out and did a video on, people don't know this, but funny car driver Robert Hyde is quite an amazing chef. We did a video of him cooking some barbecue for us. We did a video with Dale Worsham at his bowling alley and did some bowling with him. We want to make the drivers more personal. We want to tell people, here's why you should care about these people, and here's why you should like them. They have so many stories to tell, and they've never been told before. You know, our drivers, you know, when we were at ESPN, they did a great job. And look, I worked for ESPN for 10 years, and they were great to me. And ESPN was great at showing the on-track action, but they weren't telling the backstory. They weren't telling why you should care about these people, and that's what we're trying to do now with our new television package.
Now, you said your website, and I know what it is. Give that to my viewership.
Well, it's NHRA.com, and if you go there now and haven't been there in a while, you'll notice it's much different. We've reskinned the front to make it much more easy to read, and that is, we have a format that a lot of websites are going to called The River, and that is, most of the information is in the middle of the page, and you can scroll down to whatever story or video you want. There's also a link at the top of the page that has six videos on it, and you can click on any one you want to see at any given time. And there's also a little link on there that we thought was very important this year to show where you can see Fox Sport 1 in your market. So you click on that, and you just push in your zip code, and it says the channel that you have in your market where Fox Sports 1 is, because we know some people won't know that going in this year. So, but in general, the page is much cleaner, much easier to see, much easier to read, and not as busy as it was in the past. I think people will see that it's a lot easier to access information.
Somebody on your end has not been sleeping at night.
Can you see the bags under my eyes?
Coming up with all this fantastic stuff for the viewers, and believe me, it will be greatly appreciated.
Okay, folks, we had to kind of end that little that segment a little earlier than normal. It's about a 15-minute segment. But nevertheless, we're here. We're back in the seat. Hey, so I'm at the helm, and of course, I'm in the driver's seat, and I got these two characters, one to the right and one to the left of me. Now they follow me, my show. They're on
for.
I didn't call you gangsters, did I? Did I call you gangsters?
No.
Well, we should be calling you guys gangsters. You're the modern-day gangsters, man. You create so much havoc out there, it's ridiculous, man. Both of you guys. I'm surprised you're still on the air. But anyway, their show is called Mad as Hell. Mad, and these guys are always, every time I come in here, I got them to be quiet. They're wearing the back. They're causing havoc already. Wearing the back. But nevertheless, you got to love these guys. I call them characters, but these guys are fighters, man. They're fighters for the average Joe, you know. Average Joe has a problem with politics. Average Joe has a problem with business. Guess who they call? Mad as Hell guys. And they get on the air. Been running their mouth for a whole year. And I tell you, they're known from coast to coast. Believe it or not, they're known from coast to coast. So if you guys got any problem out there with any situation, anybody, and you want to be heard and you want to create some dust in the air, who do you call? You don't call Ghostbusters. You call these guys.
I'm mad as hell.
There you go.
I'm mad as hell.
See,
too.
Both of them. And these guys, I tell you, they'll dig up. If it's dirt to be found, they got big shovels, man. And they will start digging, both of them.
That's right. I used to work for the government.
See that? Don't underestimate these guys.
That's right.
Mad as hell, guys. So, what do you guys got going today?
A few things. We're going to go talk about a consumer problem. A young lady's going to call in, and we're going to talk about this, and it's a nationwide chain.
Oh.
Does automotive work. If you have a problem, or if you've ever had a problem with Pep Boys, you might be one of them.
Oh, no, you didn't say that.
Yes,
you didn't
I
say
did.
The name.
Yeah, I did.
Doggone it. You always, boy, I tell you. Did I say gangsters, folks? Yes, they're real gangsters. On the air
with
gangsters.
With real problems.
They're on the air gangsters with real problems, and they will dig up that dirt. But what's
we don't make up the news. You heard about that.
Yeah.
You
know, what's that?
Made up news?
Oh, yeah. No,
yeah, made up
we don't
news.
Do that.
No, you just dig up the dirt. That's all. You just dig up the dirt on folks.
That's it.
But it's legit. It's legit.
We left you alone.
Well, good.
I didn't go into your background at all.
Well, Joe, do that. Just... Look. I'm on Google, man. Google me. Joe Britt at Rialto. Joe Britt Rialto. And see what I've done. I'm good.
Yeah,
I'm good.
I know. He's,
I'm good.
He
I'm
is.
Good.
Number four in the city council race? Or?
Yeah, we hit number four. Man, but you know something?
He should have been number one.
I'm still
he
with
should have been the guy.
I'm still with the state. I still got my state. I'm still with the county. So I'm taking care of the county Democrats. On a county level now. So my reach has gone from seven cities as an executive for the state board to the county. So my reach is out there so I can help more people. Okay?
Good.
That's right. Good thing.
Believe me, if I get into trouble and if I need someone to dig up some dirt, who do I call? Who do I call?
Mad as hell.
There you
Mad
go. Well, folks, we got about, Carlos, we got what, a half a minute? A minute or what?
2 minutes.
About a minute? Oh, so we can just run our mouths and then just talk about nothing and the whole shot? But nevertheless, folks, this is Joe Britt coming to you loud and strong. I am so glad to be back in the shop, man. I've been out and about and doing my thing. Folks, you guys out there, you want to get to tracks? I need help. I need more correspondence. You guys, I'll pay for you getting out there. I need a charismatic young man or female. They can go to the tracks, you know, with your Gotcha Racing uniform on, and interview and bring it back to us so we can air this on a Saturday morning, okay? You can be bilingual. That's great.
Can they be older?
Yes, they can. Yes, they can.
Okay.
But hear me out. You wouldn't have an old guy at the dub concert, you know?
Don't count on it.
But nevertheless, that's what we're shooting for. So if you guys are interested in that, get back to me. 951-204-4013. Folks, Joe Britt, Gotcha Racing Live, every Saturday at 11 o'clock. And we are just about out of time. 11 o'clock here, 106.5, 102.3. See you soon. Goodbye.
Stay tuned. Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and now 102.3 FM.
Prize for its 15th straight win over Army. In just a few hours, we'll learn the winner of the Heisman Trophy. Front runner for the award is quarterback Lamar Jackson, who credits his mother for any success he's had thus far.
Everything I accomplish in life, it belongs to her because she worked so hard with me and helping me build and become as a man and the player I am today. There's no telling where I would have been without her, so I think everything belongs to her.
If he gets the award, Jackson would be the first Heisman winner in Louisville history.